Good evening, friends. The Lord be with you. Now, welcome to all of those who are joining us via live stream. We're glad you are able to worship on this Ash Wednesday. It's the beginning of Lent, and it's an important season in the life of the church, has been for a long time for us, that we sort of become a little more focused, hopefully, on who we are and therefore who God is in this season of Lent. I hope that tonight will be an encouragement along those lines. I wanted to just share a few announcements with us and with those online. If you want to come to worship on Sundays, please be sure to register online and know that there is plenty of space and that it is safe and that it's available for us. And for those who are comfortable to come, please do. We welcome you and invite you to do that, and we're glad for those who aren't able that you can join us online as well, though. That's a good thing. If you are joining us via live stream tonight, please sign the virtual friendship pad. We would like to know who was with us on this Ash Wednesday evening. Also, just a few announcements. March 14th, if you have not heard, we are having a blood drive here on that Sunday morning at the church. And it will be safe and all the precautions will be in place. But blood is in short supply in these days. And so it's really important, those of us who are able to give and willing, that we can do that. So March 14th, if you could watch for that information and be a part of that really outreach to people, that would be wonderful. I also wanted to say something for the youth. If you know of a junior or senior high child who is not busy Sunday afternoon this week, at 4:30, we are going to sled ride in the back hill of the church. So bring your own sled, bring your own hot chocolate, and dress warm. And we'll be careful and with everybody being together, but we'll keep our distance. But we thought it would be good to be outside and to see one another from a safe place and to just do a little activity. So this Sunday at 4:30 on the back hill of the church, we hope you can join us for the sled riding. I also wanted to say, for those of us who are here and have a bulletin, I didn't proofread this really well. We are not having the ashes this evening. We're not going to do the imposition of ashes. So that's in your bulletin, but that won't happen. Also, the song of confession that we're going to sing this evening will be the song of confession that we will sing through the season of Lent on Sunday mornings. We did this a few years ago. It won't be unfamiliar to you. It's a really wonderful, heartfelt prayer that we can offer. So I just wanted to make sure that we are aware of those things. Ask that you join me in the call to worship as we come before the Lord. Lord, you have been our dwelling place in all generations. Before the mountains were brought forth, or you had formed the earth and the world, from everlasting to everlasting, you are God. Teach us, Lord, to count our days, that we may gain a wise heart. Satisfy us in the morning with your steadfast love, so that we may rejoice and be glad all our days. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. I invite those at home to join us in singing, and those here to meditate on the words of this wonderful hymn as we offer our praise to God.
Rolling as a mighty ocean.
Let's join together in this unison prayer of confession. O Lord our God, long suffering and full of compassion, be present with us as we enter this season in which we recall our Savior's sufferings and celebrate his triumph. Give us your Holy Spirit so that as we acknowledge our sins and implore your pardon, we may also have the strength to deny ourselves and be upheld in times of temptation through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Ron and I heard that song at a conference we went to several years ago, and it just has been so meaningful for us, and we've now used it here, and it is the gospel story. How desperately we need a Savior, and how God has provided the Savior for us in Christ. And so I want us to remember in this season of Lent, that's what this time of reflection, sometimes introspection, ought to lead us to. Our need, but we don't stop at our need. And we understand God's provision in Jesus. And so really this season of Lent in some ways is this a time, at least for me, when it feels like we're focusing on ourselves a lot. We think about our sin, we make confession, we turn to repentance, we acknowledge our need, and it sounds like it's all about us, and it is if we stop there. But we can't stop there. And that's why we make the progression through Lent and we go to Holy Week and we realize that because of our need and in light of God's mercy and love, He has provided Jesus. So we don't stop at our need in Lent. We make our way to God's provision in Christ. And so while we are somewhat introspective, our introspection should lead us to be thinking of God, and particularly of Christ and His sacrifice for us. And so I think the danger of the world sometimes is that we become introspective and we think more of ourselves, when as Christians we ought to then be able to make that shift and make that turn and understand our need and then turn toward God and then be thinking of His glory and His goodness and His grace. Maybe I should stop there with the sermon and not read what I have written here. It's okay. So I hope that you are able to reflect on the passages on the front of the bulletin. I just want to read them, especially for those who are at home. They're just for reflection, but they also add to kind of the feeling of this theme tonight and what we're talking about. The first one is from the book of Job. Job says, "Naked I came from my mother's womb, and naked I will depart. The Lord gave, and the Lord has taken away. May the name of the Lord be praised." It sounds sad if you stop halfway. And it is empty if we don't continue to see that God is the one who provides and God's name is to be praised. And then from the book of Ecclesiastes, and it says, "All come from dust, and to dust all return." That's why we call it Ash Wednesday. The ashes represent the dust that humankind was made from, that God made man from, dust. That was our origin. That is our origin, dust. And so I wanted to read from Genesis chapter 2, that part of the creation story. It says in verse 4, "This is the account of the heavens and the earth when they were created. When the Lord God made the earth and the heavens, and no shrub of the field had yet appeared on the earth, and no plant of the field had yet sprung up, for the Lord God had not sent rain on the earth, and there was no man to work the ground. But streams came up from the earth and watered the whole surface of the ground. The Lord God formed the man from the dust of the ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and the man became a living being." I think that's worthy of reflection for us, to recognize that our origin is the dust of the ground. And from that dust, God formed mankind. But it wasn't just the form that God made. It wasn't just that form from the dust. It's the second part of that that I think really allows us to appreciate who we are. And God breathed into his nostrils the breath of life. and the man became a living being. So it's not the dust that is alive, but it's the breath of God that gave life to the man. And in fact, John Calvin would translate, and the man became a living soul. In fact, even Eugene Peterson uses that phrase in his message, that the man became a living soul because God breathed life into him. So it's that breath of God that allows us to know life and be a living being. And so as we reflect on what it means to be a living being in this world today, we recognize that it's not just being made out of the dust. It's just not ashes that we are made of, but there is a breath of God that has given us a life. And that the source of our life isn't ourselves, but is from God. Life comes from the breath of God. And the same word for breath is the same word for Spirit of God. That it's the Spirit of God that gives us life. You know, since the first week of January, we have had a lot of deaths in our congregation. And we've had memorial services, and I've done committals for many of them. And at each committal service or memorial service, I read these words: in sure and certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to Almighty God our brother or sister, and we commit their body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. For we were made from the dust, and to the dust that form returns. But there's something bigger and more than the form that returns to the dust. And that's what God provided in His breath and by His Spirit. And so I wanted to read then from the first chapter of Genesis, which is another description of God's creation of the man. And I'll start and read at verse 26 of chapter 1. And God said, "Let us make man in our image, in our likeness, and let them rule over the fish of the sea and the birds of the air, over the livestock, over all the earth, and over all the creatures that move along the ground." So God created man in His own image. In the image of God, He created him. Male and female, He created them. God blessed them and said to them, "Be fruitful and increase in number, fill the earth, subdue it, rule over the fish of the sea and the birds of the air and over every living creature that moves on the earth." And then at the very end, at verse 31, it says, "And God saw all that He had made, and it was very good. And there was evening, and there was morning, the sixth day." So we are made in the image of God. But the image of God is not what was made out of dust. The image of God is the breath of life that He breathed into us in the very beginning. And so in our season of Lent and reflection on who we are, what we really are trying to get at, what the church is trying to help us see by providing that time of being quiet and still, is sort of to recognize the part of us that comes from the breath of God versus the part that returns to the dust. And isn't that what we are all about in our everyday life? To understand those things that are temporal, temporary, versus those things that are eternal and infinite. And the things that are eternal and infinite are the things that belong to God, that come from God, and that God will sustain. And the things that are temporal or finite, that return to the dust or become rubble at some time, those things are the things that are made of the dust. And they have form, but they don't have the breath of God, the life of God in them. Psalm 104 has words that similarly reflect this. And the psalmist says, "These all look to you, God, to give them their food at the proper time. When you give it to them, they gather it up, and when you open your hand, they are satisfied with good things." And listen to this. "When you hide your face, they are terrified. When you take away their breath, they die and return to the dust." When they take away your breath, they die and return to the dust. But when you send your spirit, they are created and you renew the face of the earth. May the glory of the Lord endure forever. So again, in this season of Lent, one of the reflections is to reflect on our creatureliness, that we were created, that we aren't the creator. And that's not a bad thing, but a wonderful thing, because recognizing, confessing, and celebrating that we have been created means that there is a creator. And we want to understand our creatureliness so that we can understand the one who created us better. Hear these words from one of the commentaries I read this week on this passage in Genesis. He says, "The emphasis in chapter 2 on man's creatureliness is not without its importance. The notion that man's origin might somehow be connected with that of the divine is deliberately excluded by this narrative." And that's really important in our day, friends. The notion that man's origin might somehow be connected with that of the divine. I hear that all the time. Look for the God within you. Find the peace that's inside you. Now, sometimes people are referring to the Creator, but more times than not in our contemporary society, they're referring to what I think they believe is a divine nature in ourselves, that we were naturally of origin divine. And Lent helps us remember that we were naturally of origin from the dust. And to the dust we will return. He keeps on in this commentary and says, "Man's origin was the dust of the ground. One can also see in this picture of man's origin an anticipation of his destiny in the fall when he would again return to the dust. In creation, man arose out of the dust, but in the fall, when he sinned, he returned to the dust." So, what hope is there in that? If we simply arise from the dust and return to the dust, where is the hope? And how do we end Lent? We celebrate the resurrection. Christ. Because if Christ was simply made from the dust and returned to the dust, that would have been it. But because he was of God's Spirit, he arose from the grave. He arose from the dust. And so too, we who are given God's Spirit in Christ will also be raised from the dust again. We will rise from the grave, and there will be life that is eternal and life that is everlasting. So in this season, as we reflect on our creatureliness, it's not to feel bad about ourselves, not at all. It's to point us to the one who gives us what is good, God Himself. We do not have life in and of ourselves. Life is a gift from the one who made us. His breath allows us to live. His Spirit allows us to live forever. And that's the good news. So in this season, I do want to encourage us all that while we do return to the dust in this world, the promise is that when we are in Christ, then we are raised from the dust and given life eternal, life everlasting. That's the good news. So I want to encourage us in this season to reflect on our creatureliness, not in a bad way, but in a celebrative way, that we are made in the image of God and that God breathed into us life, and so that we don't stay focused on the creature, but then we focus our gaze upon the Creator, the one who made us, the one who has redeemed us, the one who loves us. That's the good news. Let's pray together. Father, sometimes if we slow down enough to think about these things, they can feel weighty and very heavy. But I pray that the weightiness of our reflection in this season of Lent would lend to the understanding or the gravity of how important it is to recognize that we were created. And because of that, we can celebrate that there is a Creator, one who is all-knowing and all-powerful and all-merciful and all-loving. And you have come to us and made yourself known to us in your Son, the Savior, who is Jesus. And while we were made of the dust, He was born of the Spirit. And so when we join in Christ by faith, we too then live in that same Spirit, and we can rejoice with the hope of life that is everlasting. Come, O God, breathe on us, breathe in us, that we might have life and know it abundantly. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Let's reflect on these wonderful words of this important hymn.
To
In the Gospel of John, it says, "In the beginning was the Word. The Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through Him all things were made. Without Him nothing was made that has been made. In Him was life. In Him was life. He was in the world, and though the world was made through Him, the world did not recognize Him. He came to that which was His own, but His own did not receive Him. Yet to all who received Him, to those who believed in His name, He gave the right to become children of God. Children born not of natural descent, nor of human decision or a husband's will, but born of God." Beloved, may we in this season of Lent seek to be born of God, to be born of the Spirit, to know that life, life that just doesn't return to the dust, life that isn't temporary. That life is in Christ. I encourage us to reflect on our creatureliness so that we would remember the Creator and remember that the Creator put on flesh and came and lived among us as the Savior whom we call Jesus. Let me remind you that for Sundays through Lent, we're going to be working through Psalm 51 each week, a different part of that psalm. And also, beginning next Wednesday, there will be Bible studies online for the youth and the adults, two separate groups, but both of us studying the same material, and we will take one different psalm each night on those Wednesdays. So for those who are here and those who are online, please look for that link and that e-news that comes to you probably early next week so that you can join us. Remember that we go nowhere by accident this week. And wherever we are going, God is sending us there. And wherever we are, God has us there for a purpose, even if it's at home and not at school. Or not at work. God is with us in that very place. Friends, nothing separates us from the love of God that we know in Christ Jesus. And God has shown us His love by sending His Son Christ to be our Savior. And Jesus' life, death, resurrection, promised return, that is our hope. And may the Holy Spirit, who gives life, fill you this day and every day. The peace of Christ be with you. Amen.